Hello and welcome back to the Feed My Sheep Foundation video channel. This is a video channel that studies the Holy Word of God, and we receive revelations from God, and then as He gives them, they're uploaded and I share them with whoever decides to click on the video. Okay, God bless you, and let's continue to go forward in chapter 2. We're in 2 Timothy. And let's get started. It says, thou therefore, my son, be strong in the grace that is in Christ Jesus. Thank God for his grace. Hallelujah. And the things that thou hast heard of him, of me, among many witnesses, the same commit thou to the faithful men who shall be able to teach others also. For thou therefore endure hardness as a good soldier of Christ Jesus. Because we know we are in the army of the Lord. Okay, and he says, no man that wars entangles himself with the affairs of this life, that he may please him who hath chosen him to be a soldier. So that is a chosen thing, that God chooses one to be a soldier in his kingdom and to lead a flock and to stand before people and to bring forth heaven's words, heaven's will in the earth, okay? So he says, and if a man also strive for masteries, yet he is not crowned except he strive lawfully. Okay, so sometimes you may, you know, he's talking about people who compete, okay, basically. And he says, yet is not he, if he's not crowned except he competes lawfully, okay? So, let us not do that, is what he wants us to understand. He says, the husbandman that labors must be first partaker of the fruits. So therefore, before you can begin to go forward in the Word of God, you must have the Word of God inside of you, and that is through the Holy Spirit. You have to be filled with the Holy Spirit, and basically is what he's saying right here, okay? Just giving admonition with anything, okay? That's like if before you get ready to maybe be an athlete, you've trained for it, whatever it is, you've trained for it also. You've labored in it before you can actually be a part of its fruits, okay, the investments of it. So consider what I say, and the Lord give thee understanding in all things. And remember that Jesus Christ of the seed of David was raised from the dead according to my gospel, wherein I suffer trouble as an evildoer, even unto bonds, but the word of God is not bound. Okay, so that's Paul again. Paul wrote this letter to Timothy. Okay, again, encouraging him, and he's writing it from prison, and he suffered a lot of trouble. And just as the Lord has decreed and declared, those that trouble the saints of God, he says, it is a righteous thing with him. Oh, the Heavenly Father has decreed and declared that in the book of Thessalonians. It is a righteous thing with him to trouble them whenever someone is troubling the saints of God. Hallelujah. God will step in and he will vindicate. Let me see. And that is, we can find that in 2 Thessalonians chapter 1. It starts verse 6. It says, seeing it is a righteous thing with God to recompense tribulation to them that trouble you, and to you who are troubled, rest with us when the Lord Jesus shall be revealed from heaven with his mighty angels. Hallelujah. Okay, and flaming fire taking vengeance, oh my God, on them that know not God and that obey not the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ. Oh my God. Help us, holy God of heaven. So that is the word of God that was found, again, that's 2 Thessalonians chapter 1, verse 6 through 8. Okay, going on to verse 10. Therefore, I endure all things for the elect's sakes, that they may also obtain the salvation which is in Christ Jesus with eternal glory. For it is a faithful saying, for if we be dead with him, we shall also live with him. We're talking about Christ Jesus. So rising up with him, you're going to be just like him, the heavenly, the celestial being. Okay, so going back to verse 12, it says, if we suffer, we shall also reign with him. If we deny him, we also will. He also will deny us. Okay, and that's basically verifying what was just read in 2 Thessalonians chapter 1, verse 6 and 8, because he said in verse 8, in flaming fire, taking vengeance on them that know not God and that obey not the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ. So it's very important that we draw nigh unto the Heavenly Father and receive from him in the mighty name of Christ Jesus. So verse 12 says, if we suffer, we shall also reign with him. And if we deny him, he also will deny us. So if we believe not, yet he abides faithful. He cannot deny himself. Of these things, put them in remembrance, charging them before the Lord, that they strive not about words to no profit, but to the subverting of the hearers. And then he goes on to tell us to study to show thyself approved unto God, a workman that needs not to be ashamed, rightly dividing the word of truth. So, you know, again, this is Paul talking to Timothy and telling him, because he's getting ready to bring forth the heavens into the earth to a flock. So he's telling him to study to show himself approved unto God, a workman that needs not to be ashamed, rightly being able to divide the word of God and tell the truth and bring forth revelations from heaven. Okay? So he says, but shun profane and vain babblings, for they will increase unto more ungodliness. And their word will eat as doth a canker, of whom is Hymenaeus and Philetus. I guess those were two people that did that. And Paul is talking about them, referring back to them. He says, who concerning the truth, they have erred. Those two have erred from the truth, saying that the resurrection is past already, and they overthrow the faith of some people. Okay, so we have to be careful whenever we begin to go forward and speak and stand before the Lord, that we're making sure that we're speaking the faith of the heavens, and as Heavenly Father has ordained or predestined to be spoken through us. So he says, verse 19, nevertheless, the foundation of God stands sure, having this seal, that the Lord knows them that are his. And let everyone that name the name of Christ depart from iniquity. So I want to stop right there, because God is saying right here, he's telling, Paul is saying that God, he knows everyone that is his, because he has sanctified them and he has put himself inside of them with the power of the Holy Spirit, because that is God, the Holy Spirit, the Holy Ghost, okay? And, but he says right here in verse 20, but in a great house, there are not only vessels of gold and of silver, but also of wood and of earth, and some to honor and some to dishonor. So, but if a man therefore purge himself from these, he shall be a vessel unto honor. Hallelujah. He shall be a vessel unto honor for the Heavenly Father, sanctified and meet for the Master's use, and prepared unto every good work. Hallelujah. So there's a purging that must take place. Fasting and a calling out and crying unto the heavens. So he says, flee also youthful lusts, but follow righteousness, faith, charity, peace with them that call on the Lord out of a pure heart. But foolish and unlearned questions avoid, knowing that they generate strife. They just cause arguments. He said, and the servant of the Lord must not argue, but be gentle unto all men, apt to teach and patient. In meekness, instructing those that oppose themselves, if God peradventure will give them repentance to the acknowledging of the truth, and that they may recover themselves out of the snare of the devil, who are taken captive by him at his will. Hallelujah. You know, so again, that's 2 Timothy chapter 2. As we are going forward to study the word of God, we're in the book of Timothy, the two books, the second book of Timothy. where Paul has written this book to him from jail. And again, we want to keep in mind that they are human people that have been placed into the kingdom, God's Holy Spirit placed inside of them, just as you and I, if the Holy Spirit has empowered you. If you have been converted into the kingdom, then, you know, we're just like the people that are we're reading from the Bible. They have been born again of the Holy Spirit, and the Holy Spirit has led them to write this in the Word of God. Okay, but they're writing from their own personal experience, just as I and you can write from our own personal experience, but also as the Holy Spirit has led them to write, okay? For many reasons, God wants, you know, us to know certain things. And so that is why we have the Holy Bible here on earth today. So God bless you. I want to thank you for joining me on the Feed My Sheep Foundation video channel. Thank you always for wanting to hear the Word of God and wanting to hear what thus says the Lord. God bless you once again, and I look forward to studying with you again on the Feed My Sheep Foundation video channel.